When you're planning for power performance measurements, then you have to do some terrain assessments, and we're going to do that here. So we have chosen turbine site 3, and right click here, and then say add a site calibration mast. And we are going to look for direction 100 and a relative distance of 2.5 rotor diameter. And here you can see the coordinates relative to the turbine or relative to the normal coordinate system. And we say okay. And here we see the measurement sector here. We can look at it in a little more in detail if you go to this power performance measurements and then go to obstacle assessments. There are different kinds of checks we have to make. For instance, the masts should not be in the wake of the tested turbine or other turbines. And obstacles, we don't have any obstacles yet. But then the tested turbine should not be in the wake of the other turbines here. So if you look, combine all these sectors here, then you can see that these are have some problems, and this is the free flow sector. And initially, that's equal to the measurement sector. You can also go in here and adjust this sector a little if you like. For instance, if you think that the conditions are better. Now we could try to add some obstacles as well. So I go to the site here and I right click and s I say insert an obstacle group. There are no obstacles in it yet, but I will try to add one. And actually, you can see it's this little obstacle here. I'll try to put it out here and make it larger. It's specified by the angle and distance from the turbine, or actually you can change the reference point here from turbine or mast or something else. So I'd like this starting angle to be maybe 40 degrees. And ending at 60 degrees. And now I have my obstacle here. And it was different from what I thought it would be. 60 degrees here. And then radius like this. And then it's doing some assessment here. It's calculating does it affect the mast or the turbine? And the answer is according to the standard, and that is the IEC 61400-12-1. Then it says that it's not significant because it's simply too low. And we could try to change the height if we made it 30 meter. Then I think it's having an influence. If I say 20, then it's not. So it's you can see it needs to be fairly high. Then we can try to do some terrain assessments here, and it's not very good. Everything is a problem here in this terrain, and I think even if we went to other turbines and placed the mast differently, then you won't not be able to find this place where all these conditions are perfect. You can change the mast by going in here in the menu and then change the position again. You can also, now I'm holding shift and clicking at the same time. That's an easy way to quickly search for a maybe a larger measurement sector or maybe a place where I get a perfect terrain. We can also plot the sectors, these sectors here, which matches these distances and directions where we are doing the assessment. And then now I'm zooming out, so I can see everything. And I could click the terrain here and see that behind it. You can change the transparency here so you can see the terrain behind it. Then I want to show you this what this meaning of these dots is. If I can find it, it's this one here. If the white dots, that's where the plane is not very far from the real terrain. And the blue is where it's high above the terrain, and the red here is where it's cutting into the terrain here. So it's these deviations from the terrain, they are simply too high here. And but I think we must conclude that it will be necessary to have a site calibration phase if we are going to do power performance measurements in this project.